Hi guys, what's up? A little bit untraditional now. I know that the news segment is a little kind of, I guess, tradition now, whatever. I mean, it's only been two videos, but we're gonna move away from that for this video. Talk about my running shoe lineup for right now, and then kind of what I expect to get for track. I'll probably make another video later on what I actually get for track, but so we're gonna run through what I have for this winter so far. Probably what I'll stick with for the whole winter. But who knows? We may get another shoe, like halfway through or something. But yeah, let's roll through it. We'll start with the oldest ones I have. New Balance Rebel V2 or Fuel Cell Rebel V2. You can see they're a little worn out. I got these. That one's actually kind of bad. About like halfway through track season or cross country season. And it was a great shoe for workouts, like tempos. But I mean, really, just long runs. We're great as well. Like, there's plenty of cushion on there. I mean, it feels great under the feet, and the midsole is super nice. Like, if you do want to do like a progressive or like tempo that lasts 3 miles of a long run or whatever you need to do, like, it's a great shoe for running fast. The Fuel Cell foam. I just dropped the shoe. But the Fuel Cell foam, I like better than ZoomX. It's just, it feels more cushiony and like comfortable, but also like feels just even bouncier as well. I wish the shoe had a carbon plate. I know they have that kind of version, but, or like maybe like a nylon plate. But nonetheless, like it's a great shoe, as an everyday trainer, honestly, but for those hard days, you know, when you want to go fast, really good shoe. And I'm just going to wear it probably every, like, once every other week to just get some miles in if I want to kind of try to pick up the pace that day or whatever. So, yeah, that's number one. All right, next one we got, Boston 10. Now, we talked about this shoe in the last video. I did, like, that little review, so I'm not going to talk too much about, like, the shoe itself. But basically going to be using this shoe for most of the winter. This might be one of the shoes that I replace, just because I had this shoe for, I guess I had it for about half the cross country season as well, but, so it's another one I might be looking to replace. But, I mean, it's a great shoe. Like I said, we talked about it, it's just basically gonna be a daily shoe for me, running through my site, like my main cycle. And yeah, if you want to learn more about the Boston 10 and what kind of technology it features and just other stuff it features, then check out that last video. Next up, we got the Nike Zoom Invincible. This was a shoe that I was honestly kind of disappointed in. Don't get me wrong, I think it's a great shoe. I think it feels great under the foot. But it's like a really confusing shoe because you have the full length ZoomX. So you would think, okay, super responsive fast shoe, right, with ZoomX foam, but it's really just kind of a shoe to get in the miles, which I don't know, it just kind of confused me, I guess, because it's like, if I'm gonna get a shoe for mileage, I'm gonna get something like React foam, because that's gonna, you know, like the miler, help just get you those miles. But I feel like this shoe is still kind of meant to get those miles in, maybe more of an up-tempo kind of pace, like progressive kind of run or something. But I don't know, it just felt kind of weird. The toe box kind of felt like my foot on the right side, or like on the outside, was just kind of rolling over a lot. Personally, it could just be like a personal thing, like my stride and like combined with how the shoe's made might just be for me, I guess. But the outsole wore out pretty fast, especially compared to the Adidas Continental rubber. But then, like, peeling of the outsole just, like, coming off. So, like, in my opinion, it's just, like, the build quality of the shoe is just not where it where it should be for, what, I believe, $180. I like the upper a lot. The cushioning in the upper feels great. Seems like high quality, but I just feel like the way that the shoe itself was put together could have been done way better. And I think the drop almost feels like a little much, but don't get me wrong, I think the shoe still feels great. I'm still gonna wear it, you know, like once every other week or so. My main shoes for right now are gonna be the Boston 10s and this next one that I'm pulling out right now. Deedist Solar Boost. This was a shoe that really surprised me. So you can see it's got that full length boost. Now it has this other kind of, I think they call it the solar, like Solar Boost foam. I don't know. It seems, well, maybe not, but it seems kind of like a EVA sort of blend. It almost feels like React foam actually, but Boost foam is not been updated in a long time. I mean, it's not been updated like ever. So it's a heavy kind of chunky foam, but it's still pretty responsive and cushioned. So it does feel good on foot. And so that's what surprised me was, you know, oh, Boost foam, not gonna feel that great. But when I put this shoe on, it literally felt better than all the other shoes I had tried on that day. And I, believe me, I tried on almost every shoe in the store. And the upper just like hugs the foot well, has that gusseted tongue. So it stays on well, no heel slippage. Just a good daily trainer. The one drawback, and I'm pretty sure I talked about this in past videos, but the plastic right there, I kind of naturally with my stride hit my ankle, and it's caused like my ankle to bleed sometimes, but because it just has like a torsion system, I think they call it. But this is like my main go-to shoe right now. It's the only shoe I've got bought so far for this winter. Now I've loved it. I mean, it's crazy how much I like just such a basic shoe, where in the past, like, I've been all over, like, plated shoes and all this crazy technology, but here's just simple boost, and it feels great. So I definitely recommend that. It's a great daily trainer, even on if you needed a tempo. I think it's a great shoe even for that. It's a little on the heavy side, but let's be honest, a couple ounces, are you really going to notice that? I don't think so. Maybe for racing, it'd be nice to get that little competitive advantage, but then again, you can always think about it, like, for training, if your training feels harder, then when you get into race, it's just going to feel easier. I don't know, it's just another way to think about it. But then again, you can also think of it as if you have a lighter shoe, you can run your workouts faster, so you're actually going to get more benefit. But anyways, last shoe we got here, Nike Streak. I got this shoe actually back in the summer for very cheap because I had like a lot of store credit. And it's a shoe that I wore here and there, but very seldom. Haven't worn it yet this winter, but I plan on wearing this when I start doing kind of like some like sprint workouts, just to kind of get, you know, a little bit more speed work in, like true speed work. So I'll probably wear on like those kind of runs because it's a marathon racer, believe it or not. It just has that full EVA foam and acrylic plate. So it's nothing, it's like nothing special, but has plenty of cushion. I mean, I've actually wore these on, I think 11, might have been 12 mile run. Like, it's a marathon racer technically. So, yeah, I mean, I don't think it's a bad shoe at all. I think the build quality is actually super nice. The outsole lasts forever. The outsole is interesting. It's actually another like kind of foam, just like a harder foam, which is really interesting, but it's lasts longer than most Nike outsoles anyways. And yeah, so this is going to be kind of a good kind of shoe for this faster pace workouts when I'm still getting in mileage. And I don't want to wear the fuel cells or whatever. So I'll wear those once a week at max. Probably not even actually. I'll probably wear them once every other week at max. Because I'd rather wear the fuel cells over those, honestly. And which kind of leads me into shoes I might be getting this winter, or what I plan on getting and then going into track, is a pair of Alpha Flies or Next Percents for those. I don't know if I would necessarily waste those on like speed workouts, like just sprints. I'd probably wear those more for like workouts on the track. But I want to get one of those and another like workout shoe, whether that's like an Endorphin Pro or some other carbon fiber plated shoe, or like at least like a nylon plated shoe, and then some other probably easy day shoe. Whether that's anything from like the Puma DV8 to some Hoka, like literally anything. I will see when I go try the shoes on, honestly. So I'm pretty open when it comes to shoes. I mean, I usually stick kind of to Nike or Adidas. You see, I have the one New Balance right now. And Adidas is honestly kind of new for me, but I've loved the Boston Tans and I love the Solar Boost. It's what I'll be running in next year at Arkansas State Wolves. And yeah, I mean, I actually was really impressed with the Puma DV8s when I tried them on. I never really got them because there was always one shoe that felt better than that. And I don't know, for some reason I just don't trust Puma for some reason. But maybe I'll give my chance. We'll see. Like I said, I'll make another video on what I act like when I do get new shoes. I'll throw, like shout them out or make another video later on my running shoe kind of cycle or right, cycle what I'm cycling. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get a run in today as well. So I don't know. I'm not really sure exactly how cold it is. But basically, what I want to do is we'll run a little bit with my kind of running coat. I need to take it off, come back, drop it off, and get in solid 50 minutes of running. I might go up to 55 if I feel good, just because me and Sammy went short one day earlier this week. And I did that because I was planning on doing the milk mile today, but complications, we're gonna have to postpone that. But that video will be coming if we hopefully we do it, but if it happens, that video will be coming. Hopefully Max Boyer can get out there as well. Shout out Max Boyer, go follow or go sub to him and follow him on IG. He should be there to film it, get some nice clips of throwing up and yeah. So anyways, let's get this run on the road. Maybe I'll make this kind of like a, I don't know about hype, but maybe like, kind of like the old stuff where I put music in it. Because lately, the last video was kind of a joke. I don't know. There was no music, but roll the music.
Yeah, I tear the roof up off this. My super cute when she give me a smooch, she make her lips bigger. That other doubt it ain't in it. The baby came back with the tape, brought the hits with him. All this whack putting out had me going to sleep while I'm driving. These know what it is, don't even try him. They know he ain't going for it. He get violent, won't even want him. No problems, you already know how I get. You know Jonathan, real, real, way too lit. Want my name and all kind of. She told me to go.